God is blessing our young people like never before. He is busy opening doors for them, especially the girls. God is directing them and choosing some girls and boys. You cannot believe, but God is blessing them. I was busy looking at Yolanda and I said, yes, God has blessed this girl. If you look at Wellington, they hit some young men. So I will be joining them during lunchtime. On 19 December. I will eat lunch with them. I was checking in the group yesterday. The church group. And I saw it was written, Miriam Mopafazi Mtato left the group. Thinking about that. He said, oh, I'm losing a member. And I want to challenge my young boys to tighten up your belts. We want to win and not to lose. When you are a child of God, just get excited. Just get excited. Hallelujah. Now our Bible reading today comes from the book of 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 and 10.
Because
chapter 2 verse 9 and
10.
Because we have got so many young people who are growing up, so the pastor is going to tighten up his belts and join the group as well. First Peter chapter 2, verse 9 and 10, can we all stand up in respect of the reading of the word of God?
Chapter 2, verse 9. Rudzi rutsvene, vanhu vakazviwanira, kuti muparidze kunaka kwaiye wakakudanai, kuti mubve pari. chinoshamisa. Imi kare makanga musi vanhu, asi zvino muri vanhu vaMwari. Makanga musinganzwi ngoni, asi zvino makanzwirwa ngoni.
May God bless the reading of His word.
Mwari ngaropafadze kuverengwa kwesoko.
Tinamati baba vedu vana masimba ose mstara Jesu. Tinoda kutenda imi mambo. Kuti makataura zvakanaka mukati munhu angararame nechikwabedzi asine shoko roga roga rinobva murumo waMwari. Saka ndirovirirwa tinokunda kuti muri ropa fadzi. Nesu tamira kuti titaure shoko irori Mwari wakanaka. Saka tinokunda kuzodza kwenyu kuburuke pamusoro peupenyu hwenyu kusvatingataure zvose zvibetsere kereke muzita raJesu. Amen. You may be seated.
I
have posted this passage of scripture on our church group, I think midnight around
12:30
to 1 o'clock. The topic of my message today is recognizing who you
are.
Recognizing who you are. The book of Peter was addressed to Christians who were scattered throughout the Roman world.
They
had scattered throughout the Roman world because of persecution. Things were not right with them. Most of them were assassinated because of Jesus. And some of them were wounded because of following Christ. And Peter was inspired by God to write this epistle. Recognizing who you are. Another writer was talking of a girl who was called
Sarah.
She was a very beautiful, beautiful girl. She was also intelligent and was of high caliber when she was growing up. She was well dressed, yet she had the appearance of a frightened bear. I need you to listen to the story of this girl called Sarah. She was beautiful, she was intelligent, she was a girl of high caliber, yet she was always having a frightened face. This girl called Sarah, she talked of her loneliness and of her hunger to find love from someone. She was desperately longing for someone who could give her love. As you listen to this story, a woman who was as good looking as this was supposed to have plenty of deaths and many opportunities to fail in love.
Nikunaka kwa akanga kaita mukadzi musikana uyu waifanira kunge akawana anomuda uye vakawanda vaimuda.
She was beautiful. She was very attractive.
Angai munhu akanaka uye anoratidzika zvakanaka.
But she was desperately in need of love.
Asi wanga usina anomuda.
How is it that Sarah possessed so many outwardly beautiful attributes but let the self-confident to draw men?
Chi chai kanga disika paari kuti neruna kurwake varume vazhinji vanga vasingauye kwaari.
Let me tell you, it came from her old memories of rejection.
zvaibva pandangariro dzake dzekusadiwa dzakava dzekumashure dzaakapfuura madzi.
When Sarah was 9 years, she grew 5 inches, and during junior high school, she was always the tallest girl in the class.
Paangari makore 9 achiri kuchikoro waigara ndiye angari musikana akareba kupfuura vamwe vese.
But when she was form 3, she stopped growing.
Paangasvika pazera reform 3 akamira kureba.
And now, as a woman, her height sets off her good looks. Akangoreba reba hari ku primary uko hamene zvakazoitika kwaadhobva changoita chidwarf kudai chine pameso pakanaka.
During the days when she was in primary school, she was taller, but she stopped growing and she stopped at that age.
But when she was form 3, she stopped growing. And now as a woman, her height sets her off her good looks. But she was not believing that, and she could not remove from her mind the memories of school damages.
Ana kwanza kubvisa mudangariro dzake kukanganisika kwakaitika mazuva anga ari kuchikoro.
When all her friends would be chosen and she would be left alone.
Shamwari dzake padzaisarudzwa iye aisara oga.
She recalls the hateful words of classmates calling her names.
Ano airamba achirangarira mazita akapiwa neshamwari dzake kuchikoro.
I am talking about Sarah, Sarah, Sarah. Maybe you don't know what it's like. She said to be in a group and be the only one that's not chosen, it makes you feel like a piece of junk.
Like
now we are having the rest of boys who are proposing love to girls and falling in love, and this one is standing in the church, this one is getting married, and this one, then you just remain by yourself without any girl who is saying, oh, I remember you are a great guy.
Sezvo zvakaita semazuva anaya kuti vakomana vazhinji vari kusarura vasikana vavo vachisimudzwa muchechi vachiora vachidaro iwo wosara uri wega zvokuita sekunge hauna anokuda.
When other people are being chosen or are being selected, whether within the family, whether at work, whether at home, and you remain alone, I'm telling you, it's so stressful.
Vamwe vanhu pavanosarurwa uchisara wega zvinokupa kakuremerwa nekudzangirwa zvakanyanya.
A multitude of studies in the last 40 years indicate that the way we see ourselves determines to a large degree the way we act and react in life.
Zvakanyorwa kana zvidzidzo zvakaitwa zvinoratidza izvo kuti kazhinji kacho zvatinozvitarisa tega zvinoratidza kwatichakwanisa kuenda muupenyu hwedu.
That one's self-perception, self-worth, self-esteem tends to be a governing factor in our life.
Zvatinotarisa patiri tichizviona tim zvinotipa nekuziva kuti tichave chii mangwana.
If we see ourselves as a loser, we end up to a large degree acting like a loser.
Ukazvitarisa semunhu unokundikana kazhinji kacho unopedzisira uri munhu anokundikana.
Are we together? If we see ourselves as a victim, we tend to let people victimize us like you cannot imagine.
Ukazvitarisa semunhu unogara uchitadzirwa mazuva ose unotendera vanhu kuti vakutadzire nguva dzose.
If we see ourselves as an incredible, we never came up with any creative idea.
Ukazvitarisa semunhu usina chinhu chakakosha chaakambouya nacho kana chaakaratidza,
you will end up coming up with any idea.
Unogona ukazvitarisa semunhu unoziya uyo unokwanisa kugadzira zvinhu unokwanisa kupedzisira waburitsa chinhu chakakosha.
If we see ourselves as a piece of junk,
ukazvitarisa semunhu asina basa,
we begin to think that we are garbages.
Tinopedzisira takutozviona sevanhu vasinawo basa zvishoma.
If we see ourselves as successful, then we tend to repeat successes that we have always been having since our youth.
Ukazvitarisa semunhu unokunda unopedzisa wako wakuva nekukunda pazvinhu zvose kwamazwe yomuti wako.
Like Sarah, we set ourselves up as losers. Our belief about ourselves determines our behavior. As Sarah's story indicates, the beliefs that we have about ourselves originated in childhood. Unfortunately, some of many of those beliefs are false. Many people have a negative view of themselves because of different information that they have received from those that surround them. They have been misinformed from unauthorized sources. Maybe someone has declared you as a loser from your childhood. Maybe they've just been talking negative words about yourself. Please, you need to come out of that box. The message of today is a message that can set you free. Recognizing who you are in the Lord. Recognizing who you are as an individual. Recognizing who you are within your own family members. We need to look at ourselves from a different perspective. We need to hear from an informed and authorized source about who you are. Are we together, Church of God? Amen. This message is a message that is about to deliver someone today. Maybe you have got lots of potential and God can raise you up from where you are to another level. But because of the information that is filling your mind, you are finding yourself in a closet and you cannot push through. I want to tell someone today that you are someone on the side of God. When you are a child of God, you need to get excited. You know, when I was growing up as a boy, before I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, one of my brothers told me openly that I was a useless boy and I would never give him any help in life. I was told these words when I was a boy, and now I am an old man. I still have and remember those words that guy wanted to kiss me because he was saying, I am a nobody in life. But when I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, things changed in my life. We need to look at ourselves from a different perspective. We need to hear about our life and about our future from an informed, authorized source.
tinofanira kunzwa nekutaurwa pamusoro peupenyu hwedu neramangwana redu nevanhu vanika kutenderwa kutaura zvinhu.
Now, a student in architecture entered a national, a nationwide contest for building designs.
Pane mumwe vadzidzi wezvekudraw akapinda mumakwikwi ekudraw mapapa munyika mavo.
Now judged by a panel of architects, her design received no recognition.
Vanojudge apa vakatarisa zvanga zvadrowewa nestudenti havana kuona chakanaka pazvinhu.
As they were just looking at different designs, when they passed through his design, it was as if it was just nothing at all.
Vakaitarisa zvanga zvaitwa navamwe pane yake havana kuona chakanaka pazvinhu.
They did not mention anything about his design. She was utterly depressed because the way how the judges were reacting to his designs. She was believing that her designs were the best. And now at lunch on the last day of the convention, she was sitting over an eaten lunch, looking unhappy. And also looking at her designs. Then an old man was looking at it too. At last he remarked, not knowing who had designed this beautiful architectural design. And now this man said, this one, I think, is the best of the whole lot. Judges had merely given a work an honorable mention. But one old man had liked it. The young student went home elevated and motivated. Why? Why? Because the old man was Frank Lloyd Wright, probably the greatest architect of that time.
Nekuti mukuru wanga wavarumbidza chanchadhirowa nemusikana uyu wanga uri umwe wavanhu wanga une mbiri yekudhirowa zvinhu zvakakosha.
When the authorities tells us something, we can count on it.
Kana vanhu vanotenderwa vachinge vataura chinhu pamusoro pedu, tinokwanisa kufara nezvazvo.
We can count on it.
Tinokwanisa kufara nekuda kwazvo.
Now God is the authority on whom we are.
Mwari ndiye munhu mumwe chete unokosha pamusoro peupenyu hwedu.
He is our creator.
Ndiye wakatisika.
He gives us the correct information.
Vanotipa information yakanaka nguva dzose.
He is the one we should be listening to about who we are.
Tinofanira kuteerera kubva kwavari nguva dzose.
We need to listen to God.
Tinofanira kuteerera kubva kuna Mwari nguva dzose.
Peter in the first chapter says what God has done for us.
Petrus pa chapter yekutanga unoti zvataitirwa naMwari.
If you read the book of First Peter, he was always saying, God this did this for you. God this did this for you. God did this for you.
Mukaverenga zvakanaka gwaro rekutanga ra Petro, unotaramba achidzokorora mashoko ekuti Mwari wakatiitira chino. Mwari wakatiitira chino, Mwari wakatiitira nechino.
But in chapter 2 he talks about what God says about us, not what men says, but what God says about you, David Murem.
Asika muchasa pa chapter yechipiri ya Petrus, Petro unotanga kutanga kutaura kuti Mwari wanotichi pamusoro pedu.
About me, Hofis Mutatu.
Mwari unotaura kuti Mwari unotikudi.
May I encourage the church of God today that God is not silent about who you are. And God has lots of positive things about who you are. And He is still talking about those things through His word. May God bless us. He talks about what God says about us. As believers in Jesus Christ, He informs us of whom we are. My point number one, He says, you are acceptable. You find that at verse 9. My brothers and sisters, let me tell you today, you are accepted in the Lord. You may have been deserted by friends, by relatives, or by whoever, but I want to tell you today, you need to celebrate and get excited because you are accepted as a child of God in the family of God.
You
need to know that you are acceptable by God. You are accepted by God from nothing to something. From rejection to acceptance. Most of us spend our entire lives trying to earn acceptance.
We desire that people should just accept us.
The ladies who have been pregnant, you know the story. Especially, you know, when you're a boy loving each other, so you're so special, you're my eat one now, But now when you're pregnant, then the guy begins to reject you. It's terrible.
Because we start to desire just to be accepted.
This is not new language to most of the ladies. But not just ladies, even the boys as well. When you are rejected, you feel like you are nothing. We seek acceptance from our parents. We seek acceptance from our peer guys, peer groups. We seek acceptance from our friends and partners. We seek acceptance from the people we respect and the people we envy. It's so special.
If you are respected by someone you desire to be like, you feel so special.
Our desire to be accepted influences the kind of clothes we are to put on. Hembe dzamatomuka muchipfeka nhasi dzine chekuita nokuti kana zvino ndikasvika pane vamwe vanotiona sei.
The way we are dressed today actually is being influenced by that desire to be accepted when we get amongst other people.
The kind of cars we drive, the kind of houses we buy, and even the career we choose. We all do these things because we are struggling for acceptance. Why are we so by acceptance. Because we love the feeling of acceptance. We love to know that someone has chosen and accepted us. I remember as I grew up playing soccer. No
matter
what school, we used to have team A and team B. As they were choosing the team A players out of many players, I was playing
number 7 or number 11.
I would wait eagerly, hoping to be selected. Because team A was a winning team. Now, if you were chosen by that team, you would feel great. You would feel great because of the recognition that you will get when you go in team A. On the same hand, remember how bad you would feel when they get down to number 3 or number 2 and still you were not chosen. You know, these things are common. When you are chosen and accepted, it raises your self-esteem. Hallelujah, Church of God.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
Remember, I am sharing about recognizing who you are. You are accepted as a child of God by God Himself. Some parents on the East Coast received a telephone call from their son during the Korean War. You need to listen to this story attentively. Their son was a soldier. They were thrilled because they hadn't heard from him for many months. He had gone out for war for many months without giving a call, without making any communication. And now he was coming back home and he gave them a call. He told them that he was on his way coming back home. And he wanted them to know that he was bringing another soldier who was yet in the army. The soldier was badly hit in the battlefield. Then he explained the story to her mother. He said he got hit pretty bad. And he only had one eye, one arm, and one leg. Out surely like him to live with us, said the boy. The mother, at the other side, she was excited about her son coming back home. And on the other note, now the son was telling stories about this other person he was bringing home. The mother said, "Show us, son." His mother replied, "He sounds like a brave man. We can find room for him for a while."
Mom,
you don't understand. I want him to come and live with us. The mother was struggling. Well, okay, she finally said, we could try it for 6 months or so. You need to listen to this story attentively. And the boy said, "No, mom, I want him to stay always with us. He needs us. He is only got one eye, one arm and one leg. He is really in bad shape." By now his mother had lost patience. "Son, you are being unrealistic about this. You are emotional because you have been in a war. That boy will be a drag on you and a constant problem for all of us. Be reasonable," and then the phone stopped. The next day, the parents got a telegram. Their son had committed suicide. A week later, the parents received the board. They looked down with unspeakable sorrow on the corpse of their son, who had one eye, one arm, and one leg. And it was their son who was coming back home, and the mother said, "Now."
Vakatarisa mutumbi mwana wavo vakaona zvishuwa ane soro rimwe chete, ane ruoko rimwe chete, ane gumbo rimwe chete.
They had rejected their own son and caused him to commit suicide. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you today. You know, the love of God is so wonderful. It's the love that surpasses every love. Even with our disabilities, character flaws, shortcomings, insecurities, and immaturity, God accepts us as we are. The Lord whom we serve is a loving God. Honestly speaking, I don't qualify to be preaching as I am doing, for I am not holy on the sight of God, but because of his acceptance, here am I.
And because there will be a little sumira so quickly, but you know,
the Lord whom we serve is inviting us to come back home.
He's
coming, he's inviting us to come back home without having any conditions, no restrictions. He chooses us for his team. We don't have to get cleaned up or stitched up or made up to be accepted by God. It's just the coming as we are. May I encourage the church of God today that this God that we are serving, He has accepted us with one eye, one arm, and one leg, feeling like a piece of, even when we are feeling like a piece of junk. The Lord said, my son, come back home, I love you.
Mwari wakati gamuchira, tisina dzimwe nhengo dzemwiri yenu, tichinzwa sekunge tisina kukosha.
May I encourage someone today that you are accepted as you are in the house of the Lord. Shame on us pastors, because we are failing to shepherd the flock. We are busy concentrating with the flock's problems instead of taking the flock that you are well accepted. Come and join the winning team. God accepts us as we are. Point number two. You are valuable. You are not an easy going. You are so special on the sight of God. You are valuable people for His positions. How much do you think you are worthy? I'm not talking about net here. Worthy, but self-worthy. How much do you think you are self-worthy on the sight of God? We should never confuse the valuables with the value as a person. To answer the question, how much do you think you are worthy? We need to ask another question. What determines value? Honorable Kasambira, what determines your value? I'm just saying in passing. There are two things that determine the value in life. Value depends on what someone is willing to pay for something. When someone is willing to pay for buying a house, for buying a car or a piece of land, All these are worthy what someone is willing to pay for them. Value depends on who has owned an item in the past. You are valuable on the sight of God. Based on these two criteria, what's your value? How much are you worthy? The scripture says you have been bought and paid for by Christ Himself. You know the Lord loves you. You are so special on the sight of God. You were purchased by the blood of Jesus. So you belong to the family of God. You belong to Him. You are His. First Corinthians chapter
7:23.
Who owns you? What was paid for you? Christ owns you and paid for you with His life. God exchanged His own Son for you.
vachishandisa mwana wavo.
The cross proves your value.
Muchinjikwa unotiratidza kosha kwedu.
Jesus gave his life for you, brothers and sisters.
Jesu Christ wakapa upenyu hwake kuitira iwewe neni.
May God bless his church. You are so special on the sight of God. The cross proves your value. Now a frightened woman found a place in a lifeboat. And that lifeboat was about to be lowered and move to North Atlantic Ocean. She suddenly thought of something she needed. She asked for permission to return to a starter room before they cast off.
Akakumbira kuti adzokere kuimba yake igwa risati rasimuka.
And she was only given 3 minutes. They said 3 minutes or they would have to live without her.
Vakamupa maminutes anokwana kuita matatu. Vakati kana uchinge usina kudzoka panguva iyi tinosunguka uchisara.
She ran across the deck that was already slanting at a dangerous angle.
Akamhanya zvikuru kwazvo achikudzokera.
She raced through the gambling room with all the money that had rolled to one side.
Akapfuura nemimba yanga yaine vanhu vaita zvokubheja nemari yanga yakazara imomo.
She came to a starter room and quickly pushed aside the diamond rings and expensive bracelets and necklaces as she reached to shelf about her bed.
Akapfuura akapinda mimba yake kwakusaira zvimwe zvose kurutivi ndokumhanyira.
Then she grabbed the 3 oranges and she quickly found her way back to the lifeboat and got in. Likewise, as believers in Jesus, we have been rescued into his lifeboat of salvation.
Sevanhu vakagamuchira Kristu takadzikinurwa tikaitwa miigwa yeupenyu naKristu.
Like the woman going back for the oranges, Jesus went to the cross for us.
Semukadzi wakadzokera kunotora maorange matatu. Kristu wakaenda pamuchinjikwa nekuda kwenyu.
Why? Because we are such incredible value and worthy to him.
Nekuda kwokuti tiri vanhu vakakosha zvikuru kwazvo kwaari.
One cannot begin to comprehend the incredible worthy we are to Jesus. In society value systems, we may seem like nothing more than an orange in comparison to a diamond. But to Jesus, we are the most precious treasure in all the world. So you are so special.
Tingangoita sevanhu vasina kukosha sezvakangoita maorange matatu pakati pendarama nesiriveri asi mumasuwa Kristu takakosha zvakanyanya.
You are valuable on the sight of God.
Mumaziso amwari wakanyanyisa kukosha.
So don't let the devil downplay you. You are so special.
Regisatendera wakaipa kuti akudzikisire.
I am so special on the sight of God and I'm excited because I am a child of God. Then that will lead us to our third point. We say you are capable. All these facts we gave them on verse 9. You are capable a royal priesthood. Don't look down upon yourself because on the sight of God you are very, very much capable. You are capable of doing good things that Tom and Jake can and you can do.
Unokwanisa kuita zvose zvinoitwa navamwe vari padhuze newe wamuziva.
Now that may sound a little scary to us. When the word says you are a royal priest. But Peter is saying that the two benefits that the priests have are now available to everyone who is a believer in Jesus Christ. Point number one, we have direct access to God.
Now,
we have direct access to God through prayer. We have the right to go direct to God. We don't have to pray through anyone else. We don't have to confess our sins to anyone else other than God. We don't have to experience God through anyone else. I'm saying we don't go experience God through Magaya, through Makandiwa, through TP Joshua. You can go to God directly through prayer. We can go directly to God. We have the responsibility to minister to the needs of other people. Every Christian is a minister. Not a pastor, but a minister. God says that you and I have been gifted for ministry to save others, other people. We are God's instrument to do His work and speak out for Him. To tell others of the good things that the Lord is doing. The Latin word for priest, it means bridge. So we are bridge builders.
Bridge.
So we can make people cross over. The priest is a bridge builder between God and man. We are saved to save. We are not saying what in the we are saved to save, and it's like now the major problem is that the church of God today is relaxing and is retreating instead of advancing on the area of serving the church. God has entrusted you and I with His work. We need to move very fast. The time is not on our
side.
My brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you. Don't look down upon yourself. You are capable. As the church of God, if we team up together, we are capable of doing great things on the side of God. If you believe and I believe and we get united and Zimbabwe will be saved through you and I, we have the potential of crossing over to the other side of the shore.
Ndoinini tikatenda tikabatana pamwe chete Zimbabwe inokwanisa kuponeswa iwo yamukira mira.
Highfields Church of the Nazarene, may I urge you today that let us all team up in doing the work of God. We are capable people. If we rally behind one another during church services, during funeral programs, during district programs, during evangelism programs, if we all get united, I'm telling you, we can achieve more than we have ever imagined. We are not failures. I want to tell you, even you boys and girls who are grown today, I want to encourage you today that you have got lots of potential. You are all capable of doing great things on the side of man and on the side of God. You can do it. Don't look down upon yourself. Things might be tough today, but they will not remain being tough forever. When you are doing great things, you have got to pass through a blast furnace, but you will always have to cross the other side of the shore because you have the potential of crossing over. The problem is that the church is full of people who were judged by other people and they have tended to believe what other people have said about them. And now they cannot cross over because someone has prophesied negative things about their life. And I'm saying today, come out of that closet. You need to come out of that closet. Don't look down upon yourself because you have got the potential of crossing over. The situation around us, the situation in Zimbabwe may seem to be very tough, but I want to encourage someone today that we have the potential of crossing over to the other side of the shore. And when the Lord raises you up, I'm telling you, those that surround you who will not believe that it is you.
The
Lord whom we serve is the living God.
He
is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We have boys who have already signed that they cannot pay Lobola well. They cannot wait like what other guys are doing because they think they cannot do it. You need to come out of that closet. The Lord is a great God, is the creator and the sustainer of each and every life. He, the world and its fullness belongs to Him. And you as an individual, you also belong to God.
We
have parents who think that their children cannot do it. Yes, you know what my mother was saying? When you are coming home, you must not come driving. Because you will die. But I must come by bus. So that the other people's children will be busy driving me going home. When someone is driving me, she's okay.
Nice.
When I'm holding the steering by myself, She's not so sure. She thinks I can die. We have mothers today who think that there are no boys who will come and pay cash to their children, to their girl children. You need to come out of that closet. Money is coming. Thousands and thousands of green bars are coming your way. Believe God for a miracle.
And so
the Apostle chapter 10, verse 34 and 35 says, God has no respect of man.
As
the But
in every generation, a man that seeks after the Lord is blessed.
My last point says, you are forgiven. You get this on verse 9 and 10. In other words, you are forgiven. There are no three words that communicates itself more than you are forgiven. God does not rub your sins, your sin in. He rubs them out. He doesn't release your sins like we do. He releases it all. When we come to Christ, our sins are wiped out. We will not be held accountable for them. They are forgiven and forgotten. They are gone, they are erased. And they are treated as though they have never happened. You are forgiven. You know, sometimes, but not a gererwa, it's very tough.
Sometimes when you pass, you go back to the gate. Why are you coming?
I'm sorry, my brother. Being short right now. You know, can you imagine the story of
Joseph?
When he was meeting his brothers,
he
said, "I am Joseph, your young brother, whom you have sold." Don't be afraid because you've done bad things to me. It is I, your brother, whom you have sold to the Ishmaelites. I am still alive. Is my father still alive? So don't be afraid that you have sold me. It was God's plan. I have decided to forgive you. Forgiveness is the message of the cross. Forgive, maybe forgive and forget. Forgiveness is the message of the cross. We the church of God cannot move to the next stage today because it is full of people who are not able to forgive. I am Joseph, your brother, whom you have sold. Don't be afraid. I have forgiven you. That was God's plan for me to save the world. Do you, ladies who are here, are you able to forgive your husbands? Maybe the husband was punching you in the long back. And nowadays, no longer punching you, but you are always quoting on that. Remember what you did to me that year. Maybe he's trying to say, my sweetie, sweetie, you know, I love you. I love you like him. I cannot imagine you, but if you love me, remember. Remember in the past. You are always going on the past, so the Spirit of the Lord cannot move. You are blocking the movement of the Holy Spirit by not forgiving each other. Maybe you husbands, maybe your wives have wronged you some time back. And you are still holding on to that. You have been planning to divorce 20 years ago, and you are still planning to divorce now, but you are still together. You are waiting for an opportunity to divorce. I am telling you today, release, because forgiveness is the message of the cross. May God bless you as we move to the next stage. When we come to Christ, our sins were wiped out. We will not be held accountable for them. They are forgiven and forgotten. They are gone. They are treated as though they never existed. God is in the business of forgiving sins. He can take all your sins. He can take all our past and they can be patched out. So it is with God's mercy. When we confess our sins, Christ forgives us immediately and without charge. As if nothing has ever gone wrong. In my conclusion today, so there we have these four pillars with us. The four pillars of self-esteem. Pillar number one, I am accepted on the side of God. You are accepted. Pillar number two, you are valuable on the side of God. You are so special, more than oranges, more than diamond, more than gold. You are so special on the side of God. Pillar number three, you are capable. You are very, very much capable, I want to tell you. When you were being born physically, in our old tradition, they say you were mangamaka fumba tira chimwe chinhu chakanaka mukati meruoko rwenyu.
In our Sunna culture, we say a baby is born and they are holding something within their hands.
Even though he has gone to university, he can't interpret this. You are valuable on the side of God. Point number three, you are capable on the side of God. And all your sins have been forgiven. Azvinei kuti wakatadza chinyi, Kristu akakuregerera.
No matter how much you have sinned, Christ has forgiven.
Pamwe ini samfundisi mutatu ndinogona kuita punde punde ndoregera kukuregerera. But zvisakukanganise nekuti Mwari akakuregerera.
I as Reverend Mutatu might hold to something that you have done wrong, but don't be disturbed by that. Remember that Christ forgave you.
Because of what God has done for us, we are God's handwork. We are His masterpiece. We are His creation. Therefore, we declare praises to Him for who we are. Peter goes on to say, once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. You are God's people. But now you are God's people. You had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. You and I, we have received God's mercy. We are now His own people. We are chosen. We have worthy. We are found capable. We are forgiven. When we have that and know that the world's judging system just doesn't matter.
But you know, tell us, you know,
sometimes the world will say we are junk. But on the sight of God, we are God's people. We are God's children. And we are the best on the side of God. And all the best things in this world belongs to us. With you girls, the best boys belongs to you. With you boys, the best girls in this church belongs to you. Beautiful, beautiful girls belongs to you. I can see the boys are smiling. Yeah, I picked that one. He's smiling. The best belongs to you. We have passed through difficult times. But I want to assure someone that the best days are ahead of us. The best days are ahead of us. The best days are waiting for you. The best days are waiting for your families. You think you have done it all. You are not yet. The Lord is not yet done with you. Greater days are yet to come. Azvinei hama dzangu tiri kusangana nenguva dzakaomarara mberi kwakanaka pamberi paMwari.
It doesn't matter about my relatives in Christ, but we are about to experience.
May someone be encouraged today. The world and its fullness belongs to God. You belong to God, and I belong to God, and all of us, we belong to God, and as children of God, the best is yet to come. May God bless His word. May God bless His word. I have been encouraging you today to recognize who you are. Who you are on the side of God.
Hallelujah,
Church of God.
Amen.
All the boys, they know the days, and the men, they know the days that were the days when they were proposing love to their wives. The day when the lady said, I love you and I mean it. That's the day they recognize who they are. If my dad said yes to me, hallelujah. May we all stand up. Maybe you might be discouraged because of one reason or another. This is the mourner's artery. And God is saying you are someone very special. Why don't you just come and kneel down and tell your God what you want? Whatever you want. You are so special on the side of God. You need to recognize who you are. This will help you move to the next stage. May God bless the preaching of His word. As we